Coming up, we take a look at deploying and managing Microsoft 365 powered devices with capabilities that make it possible to auto-provision new devices using Windows Autopilot and deliver apps and services including Office 365 ProPlus and line of business apps. We'll look at simplifying the management of identity, devices, apps and data with an integrated management experience and planning Windows 10 deployments at scale with tools that help you to focus readiness efforts and stay compliant and up to date. Keep watching as well to learn more about new co-management capabilities coming soon that allow you to take advantage of cloud-based modern management at your own pace. So I'm joined by Microsoft Corporate Vice President Brad Anderson. Brad, welcome to Microsoft Mechanics.
It's great to be here. I'm looking forward to this.
So with Microsoft 365, we've actually brought together Windows 10, Office 365, and Enterprise Mobility and Security. But it's not just a grouping of products, is it? What's the rationale behind it all?
Yeah, you know, this name, Microsoft 365, it's a lot more than just a branding or, you know, or a name. You know, if you think back 25 years ago when we created Office, you know, it was a seminal moment in the industry and we forever thought about what productivity in the Office suite meant differently. I think we're going to look back at this moment when Microsoft 365 was announced because it's going to have that same kind of a fundamental change in terms of what does a modern workplace look like that both empowers users and provides IT what they need. And so as I think about the work we've been doing, you know, I go back 5-6 years ago, we pulled together leaders from across the company, identity, management, security, Office, Windows, and we sat down and we said, hey, how does this all play out and what are the needs going to be in the future? And for us, it was obvious that all these things were going to need to converge because in a modern workplace, it's all being delivered from the cloud. All those pieces have got to work in harmony to deliver that modern workplace that is both loved by users and trusted by IT. That's what we've been building with Microsoft 365.
So, Brad, can you make this real for us by taking us through maybe how the user would see things?
Yeah, there's a number of things we wanted to show you here. Let's start with where it all begins in provisioning of the device. Now, historically, when organizations have received new devices, they get shipped to IT and IT goes through a process to image them. You know, that takes time, that costs money, so we wanted to streamline that. And so our intent here was, how do we enable so that devices can be sent directly to the user, they take it out of the box, they put it on their desk, and have it automatically provisioned, tailored to their needs, with the user only having to answer 5 questions.
Okay, so you've got a machine that's just coming out of
brand new PC. Let's walk you through the process now. Okay, so I'm gonna go start provisioning. It's gonna ask me for my language, my location, my keyboard, and then it's gonna come up and ask me for the network information. Okay, that's 4 questions, right? Now, one thing I wanna call out here, notice I'm not on the corporate network. Modern provisioning assumes that the user can be anywhere in the world, so you do not have to be on the corporate network. A new device can be shipped to a user anywhere in the world. So I'm gonna go ahead here and connect, and it's gonna ask me for my information on my network. I put that in. Now what's happening right now is the device is now communicating with one of the Microsoft 365 services, and look, it already knows that this device has been assigned or purchased by my company and assigned to me, and it's already beginning to personalize the experience.
So what actually happens there? How did that occur?
So this is a new service called Autopilot. And when a new PC is purchased, as it's purchased, the OEM actually notifies Autopilot of who the customer that purchased it was. And you can even get to the point you can say, this is the user, this Azure Active Directory identity is who it's assigned to. So the first time the device powers up, it communicates with Autopilot, and Autopilot knows who owns it, the company and the individual, and starts that personalization right off. So let's go ahead and put my password in. Now what's happening now as I authenticate is I'm authenticating to Azure Active Directory. It first validates that I am who I say I am. And now it's setting up this device, the settings, the applications, everything personally tailored to me based upon my unique role, my unique responsibilities, based upon my identity. Notice, you know, this device is ready for me to use. Teams has been deployed. You can see that things can be put on the start menu or onto the taskbar. It's ready to go in minutes. What used to take hours now takes minutes with the end user doing the provisioning. So I'm gonna come and I'm gonna open up Teams. Now, one of the great things about Microsoft 365 powered devices, I'm automatically signed in, not asked for my password. I can see here things that my team is working on. In this case, they want me to go and edit a document. So I'm gonna go open up this document. Now, this particular document is a customer case study of Fruit of the Loom who actually is using Microsoft 365. And so we've been going through the process with, you know, with the customer for them to review it and approve it. Now, a couple things to point out here. Notice that confidential watermark. This is using the Azure Information Protection component of EMS. And so you now see Office 365 and EMS working together to make sure this document is protected. If I come and take a look here, you know, on the file menu, you can see that this is also using Windows Information Protection, which allows us to keep corporate documents separate from personal documents on devices. Now, in this particular case, the document's been approved by the customer. So I'm going to go and change this from being confidential to public. And so just like that, the rights are changed on the file, and now this document can be published up to the web. We can start pushing, you know, organizations to look at it. But the ability to be able to actually have a file become self-protecting through Azure Information Protection is a unique capability to Microsoft 365.
And it was really cool the way that everything just came down and was provisioned on the device. You had the Azure Information Protection add-in right there inside of Word. You didn't have to do any configuration. What did you actually do as the IT admin to make that happen?
So let's actually go take a look at that. So I'm going to go ahead and go into the console here now. So the first thing, we're going to start with provisioning of the operating system. Mm-hmm. So here you're looking at the administrative console for Intu, one of the Microsoft 365 components. So I'm going to go do a search here. And you can see here I've got my baseline Microsoft 365 power device configuration here. Now, as I open this up and go look at the properties, what you're going to see is I have one place where I can now go and configure all of the settings, all the configuration for Windows 10. Okay, so you can see here, I can go and put in policies for passwords, for the store. I can put in policies for things like storage, as well as like Windows Defender. Everything that you can configure that needs to be personalized or set up on a device can now be configured through Intune. Then as the device contacts Autopilot and Intune starts to configure the devices, it uses this configuration to do that.
That looks like a pretty comprehensive list.
It is, and it's a very simple, it's a very easy way to get it done. Because that's how we provision and configure the operating system. Now let's talk about what we do with the apps, because remember, we deployed Office and other applications. So I'm going to go take a look at the applications pane here. And what you can see here is I have all different kinds of applications that I can provision on iOS, on Android, on Windows. Now let's go take a look at one of the newest innovations that we've done here, and I'm going to take a look at Office. One of the things that we've done is we now have the ability to be able to configure and deploy Office ProPlus. So you can take a look here, I'm going to go to the properties. And what this is going to give you now is a view into all of the configuration of Office as a suite, not the individual components, but Office as a suite. I can go and I can select which application I want to deploy. And through here, I can go and configure all the settings so that when a new device gets configured or a user goes and provisions Office, everything is set up according to how I want it done. Now, one of the new things that we've just added in recently is what we call Intune management extensions. Mm-hmm. And what this does is it extends the capabilities of the MDM layer in Windows 10, adding new capabilities. You think about some of the things that Config Manager and Active Directory administrators have been accustomed to, things like the ability to run scripts or set group policy settings. Let's show you one of the newest things. So let me go show you again one of the newest innovations that we've added into Microsoft 365 and specifically Intune. So what I'm going to show you here is this brand new set of capabilities that we call the Intune Management Extensions. The first thing I'm going to show you here is you now have the ability that you can run any PowerShell script on any Windows 10 device that's being managed by Intune.
Excellent.
Okay, and so it's very easy to do. You can take a look here that I've actually set up a script to go ahead and deploy the HR app. One of the things that the MDM layer has needed a little bit of help with is deploying Win32 apps and EXE apps. This is a way to do it. So you can see here, I've gone and I've created a PowerShell script. I simply point to it here, I go to the folder, select it. I've now embedded that PowerShell script inside of Intune. I can go and make the assignments to which users or groups that I want it to be done. And then I can configure when I want it to be run. Now, one other thing, just to kind of give you a teaser here, you're also going to see us add right below that PowerShell scripts a new set of capabilities to deploy Win32 apps and EXE apps, which is one of the things the MDM layer in Windows 10 has not been able to do. That'll be a part of these Intune management extensions and really gives the administrators coming from Config Manager and Active Directory a similar set of capabilities that they've been accustomed to.
So in the same portal, you have exactly what you need to manage Windows platform security, app deployment. You also showed us Azure Information Protection. Whereabouts did you configure that?
All right, let's go take a look at that now. So one of the things about Azure Information Protection is we empower the user to be able to classify documents as they're creating it. Now you can create custom labels for each organization. And so here you're taking a look at the Azure Information Protection Administrative Console, and you can see these are the categories that I have configured, and each one of them has a different set of security associated with it. I can also go and build unique policies for individuals and individual teams. So I'm going to go here underneath Scope Properties, And I'm going to go take a look at the policy that's been built for the customer experience team. You know, this is our team that is working with customers, helping them get deployed. So when somebody on the customer experience team is working on that confidential information for customers, they can actually mark that as customer information. It'll classify it as confidential, but also lock it to just that team being able to open it and see that data.
That's great from a protection point of view of vital customer information.
Yeah, and it's, again, personalizing it to the unique needs of the user and their context and their role within the organization.
Okay, Brad, this is great for setting up new users. I can see the value there. But what about for those existing users? They're also a challenge. How do we deal with their devices?
Yeah, you know, one of the promises of Microsoft 365 powered devices is they're always up to date. Mm-hmm. And so let me show you some of the things that we've built into Intune and Microsoft 365 to help organizations deploy updates to Windows. And so what you're looking at here is what we call the deployment rings capabilities of Intune. And let me walk you through a common policy. So what we're recommending to customers is that they set up rings of deployment where you start with a smaller group, and then as it gets deployed and you get more confidence in the updates, you bring it out, you know, successfully broader and broader until you deploy it to the whole company. Mm-hmm. Here's my policy. What I do here is I have about 1% of my organization that I classify in the insiders. And on day zero, when a new set of capabilities come out from Microsoft, they automatically get deployed to those insiders. Then I wait a couple of days and it automatically goes out to a little bit broader group. Okay, this is about 10% of the organization spread across the entire company. And then I deploy those updates, I deploy those new versions of Windows or updates to Windows, and then I watch to make sure that everything is working. And finally, after 7 days, I deploy that to everyone, and I broadly deploy that across the entire company. Now, Simon, if something happens, I can literally come in, I can do a right click, and I can pause those updates. And so it's all automated, but if for some reason something happens, it's literally just a right click, pause, and I pause the deployment across the organization. And the key here is with Microsoft 365, your devices are always up to date. Now, here's why this is important. If organizations want to have the most performant, the more secure, the most reliable devices, the key is to stay updated and keep updated with the updates that are coming up from Microsoft.
And people can also use Windows Update Compliance in order to be able to understand exactly how many updates have been deployed and which updates are missing inside of their organization. And we have a Microsoft Mechanics video that we just released that you can go and watch if you want to learn more about that. So Brad, lots of folks out there are trying to get started on their journey to Microsoft 365. What are we doing to help them?
And so, you know, we know that historically upgrading from one version of Windows to another has been a long and expensive process. And so what we're doing is we're taking the telemetry and all the knowledge and intelligence that we have in our cloud, exposing that back to organizations, and helping IT professionals really focus and prioritize their work to accelerate their Windows 10 deployments.
In what kind of ways? Are we looking at the apps that they're needing to deploy?
We're looking at a whole bunch of things, so let's take a look at it. So what you're looking at here is what we call Windows Analytics, part of Microsoft 365. And this is actual data from Microsoft. And you can see here inside of Microsoft, we literally have 23,000 unique applications running across all of our users and devices. Now, we have lots of dog food, lots of individually unique versions of the Office apps across the Office team. But imagine starting there. Where do you start to understand which apps are going to have problems and which ones are naturally going to work with Windows 10? So look at what we do. We start to give you prioritization and give you a focus of where to spend your efforts at. So first of all, we say, listen, the bulk of these applications, more than 22,000, are very rarely used, so you can ignore them. And we successfully walk you through down here which ones are business critical, which ones are mission critical, and you very quickly can get a list and a view of the application that you need to go verify that they are going to work and there's not going to be any problems because we know how often they're being used and how critical they are to the business.
That should be great for unblocking deployments.
Oh, you know, app compatibility has historically been one of the biggest challenges of upgrading, but we continue to do more. So now we're going to help you understand when you do have applications that have issues, how to resolve them. So you take a look here, we know that there are 206 applications in your environment that have issues. You can take a look here, you can see, you know, there's some that are attentions needed, there's some that are fixes that are available. Those fixes may be coming from the ISV. The ISV may have come up and notified Microsoft, hey, we have an update to our app that makes it compatible with Windows 10. You can come and take a look here, we can show you which drivers you need to be concerned about. And again, you can start drilling into which drivers you need to update to make sure that as users are updated, they have that great experience. Now these next two screens are some of my favorites. First of all, we're going to help you understand, hey, you've got these 20 low-risk applications. Let's help you understand what the use case of those is and if you need to worry about them. So the first thing you're going to see here is this concept of highly adopted. This is where we're aggregating data from across all of Microsoft, and we can see that these particular applications, these four, are really broadly deployed around the world on Windows 10, and we know they work, so we give you that information. Likewise, here we have a bunch of applications that have been adopted, in this case, 16. So again, we're aggregating data from across Microsoft and all the telemetry we get to help organizations rapidly be able to understand app compatibility. I love this particular screen right here. This says, listen, if you want to unblock 10% of your devices to upgrade to Windows 10, these are the things you need to go do. Go address these 29 specific apps or drivers. If you go look at these 105, you can unblock 80% of your PCs to be able to upgrade. You know, again, it's focus and allows me to spend my time where I get the best impact at. And then when you're ready to deploy, we're constantly updating this screen right here. And you can see in this case, there are 25 PCs that are ready to be upgraded. I come and I can click right down here on export. And guess what that does? It automatically exports a config manager so that the upgrade is scheduled and you're up and running with those 25 devices, getting them upgraded to Windows 10. It literally is that simple.
That is very, very cool how quickly we can do that. Do we have any capabilities to maybe work with Office add-ins? Those have been a little bit tricky in the past.
Yeah, you know, one of the well-known issues in upgrading from one version of Windows to another, many organizations also upgrade Office at the same time. Mm-hmm. One of the challenges is do the Office plugins work? So again, in this concept of proactive insights, one of the promises of Microsoft 365, we can here give you a view of all the Office add-ins that are in place. In this case, there are 286 unique add-ins being used. And you can see here what are the most commonly used add-ins, how often are they used. And again, it's about prioritizing to make sure that as you go to a new version of Office, you have these plugins ready to go so the user experience when the upgrade is done is the same as it was before. The plugins that they were using are going to work in the new version of Office.
Everything you've shown me here is a great set of management capabilities for customers that are already in the cloud doing modern management. What about those customers that haven't got there yet? Can we do anything to help them get to the cloud?
That's actually the bulk of our customers, right? If you think about it, the majority of the world today is using AD and Config Manager as they manage Windows PCs.
Yeah.
And what we're wanting the world to do and what they want to do to get to modern management and cloud management is move from AD to AAD and Config Manager to Intune and EMS. Now, you know, this has been a challenge because it's just very hard to come in and overnight say, hey, we're just going to move from Active Directory to Azure, Active Directory and Config Manager to Intune. So with the new release of Windows, we've done something remarkable. A single Windows 10 device now can simultaneously be Active Directory joined and Azure Active Directory joined. Now, what that enables us to do is a single device can be managed both by Config Manager and by Intune at the same time. That gives you this bridge to where an organization can continue to use what the tools and the process that they've used for years, start to add the cloud, and then migrate one workload at a time. So what I see happening with this is organizations will come up and they'll say, okay, I'm going to use both Config Manager and Intune. I'm first of all going to go ahead and start using conditional access from the cloud. Mm-hmm. Then maybe I'll move and start doing updates and patching from the cloud. Then I'll do software distribution. So what that allows organizations to do is move to the cloud and modern management at their own pace and what makes sense for them.
So, Brad, why should people move to modern management? What's the advantage of it?
You know, by moving to cloud services for modern management, organizations can massively simplify the work they do, make themselves more secure, decrease their costs, and deliver the best user experience. In traditional management, there are natural dependencies between the server, software, and the platforms that you use. For example, you may have needed to update your systems management software, SQL servers, domain controllers, and Windows Server version in the past in order to stay current and take advantage of the foundational updates. So when a new requirement comes along, we build a feature you need to update some or all of those pieces. In the cloud, we're constantly updating the services, and it's Microsoft's responsibility to maintain consistency across all those dependent services. So as a new requirement comes along, we can add capabilities more quickly while ensuring consistency.
It's really good to see these new co-management capabilities. I know that that's a capability that lots of folks are going to be pleased about, and it's really going to help people to be able to get to these modern management techniques faster. What's next on the horizon?
This is a constantly evolving area, and our goal is to continue to deliver integrated and simple management experiences with Microsoft 365 that support great user experiences and teamwork. So please keep giving us your feedback. We're getting more and more integrated. Of course, you can learn more about co-management and the progress of everything that we've shown you today by following the sessions from Ignite in the links below.
Thanks, Brad. It was great to have you on the show. And thank you very much for watching Microsoft Mechanics. Stay tuned for the latest in tech updates. See you next time.